improv.
Pierre has seen improv before. Two great teams up tonight. All we're gonna need from you to get started is just a word of suggestion. So on the count of three, say a word that pops into your mind. It can be your favorite word, your least favorite word, any word. One, two, three.
Yes!
Amazing. All right, now with that energy, give it up for Heirloom.
I'm losing.
go outside, not be grounded. I look at her face and it disappoints me.
You're my only friend who lives in a perpetual state of groundedness. It's like I always call you like, hey, let's go play catch.
Sorry. I know you should be laughing because you're drunk and really pissed off. This is so great. You can't learn from your mistakes. It's just one thing. You don't lose anything else. It's just a Spider-Man lunchbox. It's fucking hilarious. Why the lunchbox?
It's the pressure.
We're 13. You should keep carrying a Spider-Man lunchbox anyway. I know they're your best friends. We've known each other since we were. We're 23 and a half months, but like, I'm trying to be supportive. It just came out. There have been so many iterations. You can't even keep track anymore between that movie. Tobey Maguire, other people.
Can you just help me look?
You don't remember where we found it last week, the week before? The week before that?
Yeah.
Man, I should start recording these on my phone, so I can post them as some sort of art piece.
It was the last place I thought to look.
You don't remember what that was.
Oh. Hey guys. Thanks for coming over. So I wanted to talk to you a little bit. Wait, is everything okay? Are you all right?
Fine.
Good. So, like, I know we're, like, best friends. Well, we've been best friends, like, ever since ever, right? I mean, and what I'm trying to say is I've just been feeling really, like, vulnerable lately because I just wish we could do more things together, you know? Like, you guys are always going to Pilates together, and like, you went to the roller derby together, and you went to that third place, the ice cream parlor together, but you never invite me, and it's just making me think, like, maybe you don't want to be my friend.
Well, no. those are like, our things.
Pilates, the roller derby, and that third thing, the ice cream parlor, those are your things?
Yes.
But they're not two-person things. Like, they could be very well could be three-person things. No. But Jennifer, we're the ones who first started doing Pilates together. It's true. Teeth. Jennifer and I learned about Pilates like 6 years ago. And roller derbying, well, I guess that could be your thing, but I've been getting two scoops of vanilla with Steve since kindergarten. We have extra sprinkles, right? So all I'm saying is, like, you could invite me to do Pilates, and you could invite me to go to the ice cream parlor, and it could be our thing, like, the three of us our thing.
Okay. You get one try.
One try in all three of those things?
Pick one.
Okay, ice cream parlor. We're all gonna go to the ice cream parlor together, and you'll see that I can be a friend asset. I can be great. In fact, we don't even have to go to the ice cream parlor. I have ice cream right here in the fridge because I knew this was gonna happen because I know you guys so well. Because we're best friends.
Okay, that's a little creepy.
Thanks for coming to the scary movie with me. Look, I know it's not your thing, but I really appreciate it. I can't go alone.
you're hanging out with me by default. Right.
You said you needed somebody to come. I'm here. No, it's been.
So it's Sunday afternoon. Football's not your thing. I invite you to a quiet place, and you come just because you got nothing better going on.
No, I didn't say that, Greg. It's because we're friends, and that's what friends do for one another.
Oh, that's really nice.
Thanks.
What? We're both popcorn. I brought you. Favorite fleece blanket.
Oh, thanks. Fleece is.
You don't have to eat popcorn. You don't want to eat popcorn.
Oh, thanks. Can we trade?
Yeah, we'll trade. Yeah.
Thanks, Greg.
No problem, Jack.
So, why do you even like the Titans anyway?
I mean, I grew up there, you know? I mean, I don't know, my dad really instilled upon me, like, a great love of the home team.
I get that. I really like the Baltimore Art Museum. Home Art Museum.
I feel like you don't want to watch this movie.
I'm here with you watching, like, it's the previews. What do you, like, I'm here.
All right. So the reason I had you come here is, like, if I go see a scary movie alone, I'm going to flip out. I'm just going to lose my shit.
So, by me just being here, you're not gonna, like, lose your shit?
Yeah.
Or are you gonna, like, be weird?
No. I think that you'll help, is what I'm saying. Like, I won't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Why did you want to go to a scary movie if, like, they frighten you?
I think it's, like, kind of exciting. It's like that thrill, you know, like, what if you're gonna die?
That doesn't really.
But then you're not, you know, like, it's like, oh my god, we solved it, thank god, you know.
Okay, guys, it has to be perfect. When I requested a flash mob for Sierra to propose, it has to be absolutely perfect. I want my love, my truth, my confession to her. She has to know. You know, this isn't even part of the flash mob, but I appreciate it all the same. Thank you so much. I need to go that direction because the water bowl is here and the camera's waiting by the hour. Listen up, guys. When I pull this ring out of my pocket, I need you to scream like your little face has never seen.
Horrible.
Yeah.
Yes.
Scout exercise in other ways. I briefly played catch.
Yeah,
it was quite nice.
Okay. Well, do you want a snack?
No. There'd be no reason why I would want any food at all.
That's true. I did pack you an extra big lunch today.
Yes, it was so delicious. Thank you, Mom.
Tuna fish.
Oh, it was incredible.
You know, maybe I should wash that. We should wash out your lunchbox. It's tuna fish.
You know, I actually wanted to savor it for a little bit longer.
The smell? You
want to
savor the smell?
It was so delicious. You just wouldn't believe it. You would not believe me.
Oh, sweetie. I mean, I do make a good tuna fish.
It was incredible. All right, well, I'm going to go play outside. Thank you very...
Are you sure you don't want a glass of milk?
No, there's, again, no reason why I, as a growing child, would want any food or substance at all.
Winnie, you're being a little... You seem nervous.
I'm excited. I got an invite to play kickball, and,
But you're afraid of balls.
Terrified.
Sweetie, why do you want to play kickball?
It's outside.
Vitamin D is always a good thing, but honey, you seem like you're not being honest with me. You know that in the Johnson family, we're always honest, right?
That's what you tell me.
Yeah. Dumpling, come on. Sit down. Sit down, Dumpling.
Let me tell you something. Very honest.
Okay. You can tell me anything.
I don't really want to play the kickball, but I was invited, and it seems quite nice. There are children outside playing freely in the fresh air, just out there, youthing it up. And I would be afraid if I tell you that I left my lunchbox at home, you would frown at me.
Okay, so, Mom and Dad, I don't know, Dad thinks I've been a little weird for kind of my whole life, but I just feel like I want to be included as part of this family. You guys were best friends, and you made me, and I just feel like I've been fending for myself for the last 14 and a half years.
We've been down this road before.
I don't know. I'm going through, like, puberty, and I'm just feeling really good to have, like, your support, and I just have to, like, read stuff on the internet. You guys...
We can tell you all about that.
You know, I just want...
What?
Sorry.
Okay, sidebar. Okay. Yeah, 28 years?
And I just feel like sometimes I get a little out of sync. I'm starting to doubt.
Okay.
We're on the same page.
I understand. I can do better. I promise. I absolutely can do better.
I know,
I love you. Sidebar.
I mean, you guys never really volunteer to tell me anything about, like, my body or how it could be changing, but if you want to now, I mean, like, I would love to be included.
Well, Jessica, you're becoming a...
Okay, sorry. Oh boy! The rebel yell, I haven't been on this roller coaster in never! Get your roller coaster seatbelt down because we might die, and people die,
Gregoria, I came here because you asked me to be here.
Yeah.
I just don't really like, you know, amusement parks.
What?
Yeah.
I mean, you might have said that once or twice when you, like, ignored my text messages, but you're here with me now. I'm terrified of this, and I knew that you're such, like, a killjoy. You're gonna take all of the scariness out of the situation. Everyone. Thanks so much for going to therapy with me. I know we're not like a couple, but I just feel like I'm scared of opening up, and I just feel like you can really be super helpful to me, you know?
Listen, Regina. I came here because you asked me to. Not because I want to be here.
Oh, man, I just gotta tell you again, thank you for being my best man. This is a big day for me, man.
Oh, no. Listen, Gregifer.
Yeah.
I don't really want to be here. Like, you texted a couple people, and I mean, I've said yeah because you're my friend, but like, you know, other people would have been maybe a better choice. I don't.
Dude, we've been like bros for a really long time. We have matching flannel shirts.
Tell me one thing about myself, Greg.
Thanks for coming over.
My daughter.
Gangster, I just really didn't want to be the one to give your eulogy, you know?